This is the shelf that we have available for flu vaccine, and as you can see, we don't have any.
It's not an easy conversation to have with parents, but
I unfortunately wasn't able to give you the flu vaccine.
Pediatrician Jacob Rosenberg is having it.
People are getting the vaccine. Unfortunately, we ran out.
Leaving six-month-old Jessica here and other young children in Ontario vulnerable to a flu strain that's hitting them particularly hard.
To not be able to give a baby at 6 months old, the highest risk group, just seems absurd.
And it's not too late. Flu season happens in waves. As the first strain begins to wind down, Dr. Rosenberg says another is coming.
Now, influenza B can be particularly dangerous for children, and to not have an opportunity to be covered against it is a shame.
Ontario Public Health says there is flu vaccine in the system. Problem is, it's largely in pharmacies, and they aren't authorized to vaccinate children under the age of five. While other provinces are also beginning to run low, Nova Scotia is actually rationing flu shots.
I was surprised because we never thought that we will run out.
The province's chief medical officer of health is asking that pharmacists collaborate with local physicians to ensure children have access to vaccine. But moving the vaccine around is harder than you might think. It must be kept cold, but never frozen. Having flu shots change hands can threaten their effectiveness.
It looks obvious that rules should be broken, but those rules are actually there for very good reason to protect the safety of our vaccine supply.
After being turned away by walk-in clinics, Danielle Plack says a family doctor finally gave Jessica a dose of flu vaccine. But young children need two.
It is frustrating.
And there's no guarantee she'll get the second dose for protection. Christine Birack, CBC News, Woodbridge, Ontario.
One last sobering statistic in all this, 13% of all reported flu deaths this season have been children.